Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're here today in Nashville, Tennessee to introduce a voice to the world. And it's one that's not easily understood for two reasons. He was born a hair lip in a charity ward in South Carolina. And he doesn't talk plain, so you'll have to pay close attention. And two, the majority of the listeners to this record have instant disbelief in themselves. And you may even find it hard to believe what he has accomplished can happen to you too. The man who is behind this voice you're about to hear is a living example that anyone can achieve success when they develop the proper attitude and self-confidence in themselves. You'll read about his life story in John Frasca's bestseller, Con Man or Saint, how he borrowed a $5,000 investment and now has turned it into 41 corporations worth over millions and millions of dollars. This man we are here to hear today is a symbol of hope. He's a symbol of the American dream, what free enterprise can do to young men who have a burning desire and want to achieve. He's here to show you how you too can become great because you were born to be. Dare to be great. Now just what does that mean? Well, he feels every person was born to be great. Born to be a king, the world is throne. But very few people step up because they don't believe something great can happen to them. We're here today to tell you that something good can happen to you. Listen closely and see if you can find the little spark that'll get you going. Listen as he tells you his background and how he overcome obstacles, and you'll find that the bumps up the mountain are what you climb on. You'll find that the obstacles that you face every day will give you the key to success.
And we believe that that's good judgment. And the way you obtain good judgment is through experience. And the way you obtain experience is bad judgment. This man has taken the bad judgments made in life, used it as experience, and turned it into good judgment and become a phenomenal success in his time. Dare to be Great has four courses. The first course is an attitude course to give you the terminology, the goals, the purpose, the desire in life that you need to achieve success. It shows you how to start, how to begin. Adventure 2 is a follow-through course, an in-depth study of the human personality that probes into the self to give you self-understanding so you can understand others. And then you'll become the success that you were meant to be. You'll achieve your heritage. Greatness in the individual. Adventure 3 will teach you what you need to know about salesmanship. And the first thing you'll find out is that you have to know how to sell yourself. Then you can sell yourself to others, and then you can sell products. Adventure 4 is the art of success with people, getting along with people, being able to handle people, being able to understand people. If you want an executive position in the job that you hold today, this is the course you need to take. If you want to learn how to get along with others, this is the course you need to be in, because that is Glenn Turner's secret.
And he'll share it with you today. He doesn't hide it. He shares his success with others. And you'll find that the only talent that this man proclaims is the ability to organize other people's talent. And you do this through the practice of getting along with other people, being able to manage people. If you're interested in success, if you have a burning desire, listen to him closely as he shares his background and knowledge with you, and you'll find out you too can achieve exactly what this man has achieved if you'll just believe in number one, believe in yourself. He has a dream to share with you. He would like to go down in history as the man who helped more people than anyone else. He would like to be remembered as the person who was greater than his dad and will leave behind him a heritage for his children to become greater than him. Listen as he speaks to you, as he brings his message that he's shared all over the world now, an international traveler who spans the length and breadth of this continent in his jet, goes to thousands of people and audiences all over the world, is a world-renowned speaker, is requested now in over 23 countries, has a full-time job just meeting the people in his organizations all over the world, a phenomenon in his time, a man that you'll read about in history, a man that you can respect because he's a living symbol of what America is today and what you can become. The chairman of the board of Conscott Interplanetary and the Dare to Be Great philosophy, Mr. Glenn W. Turner. Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first thing you have to learn to be great is you have to know the secret. And the secret of Dare to Be Great and my secret of success is I'm a user of LSD. The real drug. A drug that can really turn you on. You'll never have any depressed moments. You'll never have any bad feelings. It's called love, service, and dedication. If you get turned on with these three things, you need no false drugs, like your mind pushed around the corners and in the dark alleys. Because love for your fellow man will help you out in the world the right way. Service to mankind and dedication to yourself and your family to provide a better way of life. Most people are afraid. And Dare to Be Great is the hardest work you'll ever sell to man. You can sell a product because everybody believes in a product. But when you sell Dare to Be Great, really all you're selling is a man's belief in himself. Now he'll pay $5,000 to $10,000 in college, and he'll drop out sometime the second year, the first year, the third year, and he won't gripe about losing his money. But in Dare to Be Great, if he's not automatically a millionaire in 2 or 3 weeks, he may just blame you for introducing you to it. And the biggest trouble you'll have in Dare to Be Great is his friends and his neighbors and his loved ones will start telling him it won't work. Because when I first tried to be great, my lawyer told me that I was going in with a phony philosophy, that I couldn't become a millionaire, that I had a hair lip, that I was born on the wrong side of the track, and I was never going to get over it. And I let people like this influence me. And they got a $5,000 check, a company that was teaching me a symbol of being great. Nothing like we have, but it was a start. It was a beginning.
And I went back and asked my lawyer, and when he got through with me, my stomach felt like it had knots in it. I had butterflies. I couldn't eat supper. My wife cried. And I demanded my money back. I didn't get it. And while my lawyer was suing him, I made $28,000 determined to prove it would work. Being great is a simple thing. It's easy to become a multi-millionaire. It's easy to have success. And keep in mind, success is being happy doing one thing. But the hardest part is believing it can happen to little old me.
That was my hardest thing. Once I ever believed it could happen to me, and once I ever made up my mind, nobody ever stopped me. There's nobody in the world can stop Glenn Turner and the people all over the world that believe like he believes. You'll have a lot of people that will join us. And 3 out of 4 of you that join us will not be great because you'll make up your mind that you're going to start off and you're going to do something. You're going to be somebody. And all of a sudden, one of your friends or one of your relatives or some public official or somebody, some newspaper article, somebody will say, "Dare to be great, ha, ha, ha." The greatest con game in the world. Because this is what they said about the Christians, and they threw them in the lion's den. This is what they said about Billy Mitchell, and they court-martialed him for trying to start a thing called air power. Ridiculous. This is what they said about Stewart, who purchased a Laster for a little over $7 million. Stewart's folly. Ha, 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 ha. Daring to be great. People will ridicule you, they'll laugh at you, and they don't mean any harm. They simply have never bothered to look. They've never bothered to fly to Orlando to see for their own self, to see with their own eyes. And keep in mind when you come in Dare to be great, that we're not asking you to come in Dare to be great, to sponsor other people in the Dare to be great. This is your choice. And you must take invention one, invention two, invention three, invention four, and then you must pass a qualified test before you can sell the courses. That's no great thing to pass that test. It's just a matter of you having an attitude. And unless you believe in yourself, you should never try to sell anyone else on it. Because unless you get your own house in order, you can't put everybody else's in order. So you're not buying the rights, and there to be great, to sell courses. You're simply buying the right to better yourself, improve yourself, to learn how to work and to handle people. If you can listen to me and you can believe every word I said, for 30 days, if you do everything I tell, and you was enthused as I was, and you'd make up your mind, you were determined to never give up, regardless of whatever happened, nobody can sway your fate. If you had a wife behind you that had a backbone instead of a wishbone, if she believed in you like my wife believed in me, if she looked at you with admiration, if you thought you was the greatest man that ever drawed a breath on this face of this earth, you could become this type of person. It's very simple to be a success. But the only place success comes before work is in the dictionary. And you must work hard. You must make up your mind. You must allow no one to change it. Most people will lollygag around and poke around. It'll take them week and week to make up their mind. And then once they make it up, the first guy that comes along or yell, that laugh, that'll make fun of them, they won't be a Christian anymore. They won't be willing to go into the lion's den to defend the cause. See, there to be great is not just a philosophy. It's a movement. It's a movement that will become the international language of the world. It will teach black and white and red and yellow and people of all languages and all denominations to love one another, to respect one another, to have the guts to stand for the conviction. It'll be the most criticized company that's ever came out of the face of this earth. It'll be ridiculed. It'll be beat upon. There'll be laws to be trying to pass against it. And we'll have to contest many, many, many laws. It'll happen in your state. It'll happen in your city. It'll happen in your area. And the people that contest the laws will be the one that wants to keep. The small investor, small. He don't want you to have anything. He'll try to keep the 98% who are working for everybody else. And the 95%ers who cannot think for themselves. He'll try to keep them down. Because 5% of the people in this nation, and every nation in the world, control the mass majority. They put fear in you. And now you're small. And now it's not possible. It's a dream. Glenn Turner, you can't make it. You got a hair lip. Glenn Turner, you were born in a charity ward. Who are you to think you can do something? Glenn Turner, you'll never make it. I'm not buying that, Neil Dickinson Turner. 37 people I talked to and 37 people laughed at me when I began my first company. Because they said, you're a dreamer. You're a schemer. You're never going to make it. And now they're calling up wanting to go to work and run one of my companies. They didn't even believe they could run it when it wasn't nothing. How can they run it now that there's something? Dare to be great. It's easy to be great. The hard part is believing it can happen to you. To happen to you and I. I wish I could read through this record, through this tape recorder. I wish I could lay my hand upon your head and do like Oral Roberts or Billy Graham and give you instant belief in yourself. Because in this modern day and age, we have instant coffee, instant tea, and instant disbelief. We've been literally brainwashed from childhood in believing in reading and writing and arithmetic. And we've been told over and over that 2 + 2 = 4, and it's a lie. I've been getting $1,000 while you've been getting 4 because I cannot add. It's as simple as that. Do you think we landed on the moon? I called up Dick the other day. And you know what the real story is? Well, we've been blowing so much money trying to get to the moon that people were criticizing that when that camera was shown, it wasn't shown on the moon. It was shown on the desert out in Nevada faking that landing. Now, you don't believe that, do you? It could be true. How do you know? You wasn't on the other end of that boob tube camera. You wasn't on the other end. Waller wasn't on it. Hunt wasn't on it. How do you know it's not so? Well, the government said it was okay and the government wouldn't lie to us. You think you elected the president? The big corporations in America elect the president. The lobbyists, there's more lobbyists in your state capital than there are senators and representatives. And you know who pays their salary? You know who brainwashed the legislator? The big mass corporation that wants to keep you working for them. Now, if you're happy working for a big corporation, you'll wealth the individual and you'll be a fool to ever leave them. You should just learn all the techniques of handling people and getting along with people so that you can become the manager, the foreman. You can become the president of that corporation. And if you can think and believe harder than anyone else you work with, you can reach the top of that corporation. Everybody doesn't belong in his business himself. Strive to be a great preacher, a great lawyer, a great politician. Strive to not be corrupt. Strive to put yourself in the other man's position. The people that we're trying to make understand our philosophy of dare to be great are the ones that really need our courses the worst. It's ironically, but this is the way it was when we fought our independence from England. This is the way it was when the English fought their independence from other people that have them in captivity. The black man says, I'm a slave. I was a slave. My grandparents at one time, way back down the line, they were slaves when they became Christians. You see, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, most of you out there listening to me through this microphone do not believe in yourself and never will believe in yourself because you've been taught to think small. You've been taught to listen to other people. You cannot even make a decision for yourself at this moment. You have to think it over. You have to ask somebody. And chances are the man you're asking is making more or less money than you're making. But you believe him because you trust him, even though you don't know what he's talking about. See, ladies and gentlemen, no matter where you're at tonight, listen to the sound of my voice. You could be great. There's only one hang-up. You have to believe it. And that's the hard part. You haven't been taught to believe. You've been taught to disbelieve. You've been taught reading and writing and arithmetic, and you've been programmed. Your mind has been lost. At the age of 2 years old, a computer was replaced by your brain. Your brain was shoved into the back, and a computer came in the foreground, and you were told all the things that you had to do in life. You were told that this would go wrong, and that would happen. You couldn't be happy. You were told, maybe you can, hope you can, don't think too big. If you're rich, you can make it. You got to have the contact. You got to know somebody in the government. You got to do this. You got to do that. And in most cases, you're right. Only the strong. Only the strong that dares to be great. We're looking for the Gideon army. The army of 300 men is all we really need. You see, one thing that makes Glenn Turner what he's become, and that's faith. That's my whole Bible. The word faith, I don't have to read and study and pray over and over and bother God with the same detail. Wouldn't it be nice that we all would believe God when he gave us one word, faith? It'd save a lot of writing, a lot of printing, and a lot of money. We could take the money we spent for the Bibles and put it in something else. Oh, well, I need all that. Maybe you don't. Maybe if you really believe, you really believe in God, you could just put one word on the wall that says faith, and it'd be your Bible. Because my Bible is in my mind. I can open it anytime. My computer no longer exists. Your computer has been programmed to say you can't. I've got more confidence in people all over the world than they got in themselves. Because Glenn Turner made it from a charity ward with a hair lip, an 8th grade dropout. I made it because I was too dumb to figure out how it wouldn't work. I didn't have any intelligent friends that discouraged me. I believed in the philosophy of Abraham Lincoln, of George Washington. I believe in the philosophy of Henry Ford, of Henry Kaiser, of the Rockefellers. I believe in the philosophy of the men who went out and did it in spite of the ones that tried to stop them as they did it. You see, the little world will try to stop you when you dare to be great. And sometimes they mean well. Sometimes they love you. They're concerned. They're trying to protect you. But they really don't know any better. They simply don't even have the fact. How do you expect to convince a man in 30 minutes to believe in there to be great, to believe in himself, when it took him all his life to foul up his mind the way it is and not believe he can do anything? How do you expect a man to believe instantly when he's been taught instant disbelief. He has hearsay. People don't think. No one uses their own mind. It takes them 2 years in college just to figure out what to major in. Don't be too critical of these people. Love them. Try to get them to understand you. Many people in my hometown are not in my company and are not millionaires now and are not happy because they listen to a lawyer. They listen to an influential personality in that particular area. And they fell by the wayside. And they said, oh, Glenson, if you'd have been stronger. Glenson, if you'd have been a senator, if you'd have been a TV personality or a newspaper reporter, if you'd have been somebody with some credibility, so that I could have listened to you and believed you more than them. I would have been where you are, Glenn Turner. I would have been sitting up there with you. I'd have been happy. And ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the happiest man you've ever heard in your life.
I have no fear. I have no doubt. And if I die today, I'm living the most beautiful time of life. I have hundreds of thousands of letters in my file that if I never make a dime, if I never sell a horse, Glenn Turner, you have changed my outlook on life. I'm now selling twice the real estate I used to sell. I am now have more milk customers. It's whatever your thing is, that's what we're here to improve. And you that are listening to this record for the first time, the man tomorrow will ask you for a check. He'll ask you for $300, $700, $2,000,
$5,000,
or possibly even
$5,500. Depends on what section of the country you're located in. He'll ask you to put your money up. Because if you don't believe it enough to pay for it, it's just like a college course. You're not going to get anything out of it. But the nice thing about Dare to Be Great, once you get the horses, we need agents. And if you qualify, you can become a sales agent and earn your money back. But 3 out of 4 of you won't get a thing out of this course. Not because you can't. It's because you'll disbelieve everything you take and everything you hear. And every time we cram it into you, somebody else will cram in a negative thought. And you'll listen to them more than you will us. And therefore you remain small and aimlessly all your life. It's unfair, but that's the way society is. 95% of the people are failures. They are failures because they listen to the other 95% who are also failures. You have to make a stand. You have to make up your mind. The difference between Dare to Be Grace and other motivation companies is simply this. Other companies will sell a franchise for a state or an area for a flat fee of $10,000 or X number of dollars. And then, that one man, or he'll sell you a hamburger franchise for $30,000 or $100,000, or rug franchise, or what to name it. And then, that one cat that can afford $30,000 or $100,000, which most of us cannot afford, will go out and hire a bunch of salesmen like yourself. And he'll con you into working for him for $10,000 or $20,000 a year while he makes hundreds of thousands of dollars. And that's okay. Because the rich man stays rich, and you keep doing all the work. It's not how hard you fall, it's how fast you get up the count. The only time you're failure is when you die and go to hell. Our course works this way. Once you take our courses, and you have the outlook and the attitude you should have, and you believe it, like you believe your religion, you may then apply for a sales agent position and go out and sell a course. A $300 course and make yourself $100. You can sell a $700 course and make yourself $300. You can sell a $2,000 course and make yourself $900. And you can sell a $5,000 course or a $5,500 course and make yourself $2,000 or $2,500, depends on your local areas. What's wrong with that? You don't know what's wrong with it? It ain't fair. The poor people are making money. The poor people are getting rich. That nut's driving a Cadillac when he ain't even got but a 9th grade education. We don't like that. Keep him small. Tell him he's crazy. Get to his attitude. Keep him down. Don't let him know this is really America.
You are the master.
wherever you are tonight, no matter what world you're in or what country, you're the master of only one thing you can be sure of, and that is your mind. And most of you have turned it into a computer, letting other people tell you what to do. Don't believe in nobody unless they're willing to share their profits with you. Don't you work for up, and it won't allow you to get out of the stock when it hits the stock market. Don't you believe in anybody unless they totally investigate the fact. Make your own decision. Get the facts from everyone, and then make the decision from the facts of all sides. I've enjoyed talking with you, and I look forward to the day when I meet you in public. And one thing I promise you, Glenn W. Turner will never, never, never give up. And nobody will ever stop us, because we're going to teach love throughout the world, unity and understanding that all men deserve the right to make decisions for themselves. God bless you, each and every one of you, wherever you're at. Thank you.
Mr. Glenn W. Turner. Mr. Glenn W. Turner. Mr. Glenn W. Turner.